Hey everyone, Jason here, digital marketing consultant, and in this G Suite review, you're going to discover the top 5 reasons we use G Suite for Business to run our digital marketing agency and how it can actually be more efficient and economically effective for you compared to other solutions like Office 365 and Zoho Docs. Timestamp table of contents in the description. So before we dive into the top 5 reasons you should be using G Suite for Business, let's go ahead and take a look at the pricing tiers, because there's 3 of them. We have the $6 a month, the $12 a month, and the $25 a month. We'll ignore the $25 enterprise, because that's really only if you need some really advanced data management and retention and security. Most people don't need that. So for 12 and 6, the main differences are 2 things. Number 1 is your file limit storage. So at $6 a month, you have 30 gigabytes per user, and at $12 a month, it's a terabyte, and then if you have more than 5 people, then it's just unlimited everywhere. The second difference between the two is the ability to use their app development platform, although most people don't really use that, but I just wanted to include that in case you wanted to develop some internal apps or advanced workflows. Now, the very first reason G Suite is awesome compared to the other solutions out there comes down to the ability to edit documents in real time. So as a quick example, with this particular video, I'll go through and create a content outline, and then other people on the team can read the content outline, modify the content outline, and then create slides or update our Google Sheet that manages all of our video content all in the cloud in real time, and there's no revision problems because you can actually go back and see all the changes that were made, and everyone knows if they're looking at a spreadsheet or a Google Doc that it's the most current version. And of course, you can add comments and you can have multiple people contributing to the document at the same time in real time. This is a huge thing that we use weekly during our founders meetings. Myself and my business partner, we always have our agenda in a Google Doc, and so we can easily add and delete things as we go through our meeting. So it's very, very easy to use. And what's great is something, if you're still using Office products, you can actually use Google Drive on your desktop and it will tell you if someone else is in that same file. So you actually don't even have to worry about revision management if you're still using Office products. So you don't have to pay Office 365 in order to know if someone else is editing. So if you open a Word doc and someone else across the globe, anywhere in the world, is also in that Google Doc, it will actually tell you and say, hey, this person's in there, and then you can jump on whatever channels you use to communicate and ask them to get out or just wait until they're done. And that way you're not both editing the same Word doc or Excel sheet at the same time. So it's very, very cool. Now, the second reason we really like G Suite for Business comes down to the team drives function. So if you are using the free version of Google Drive, you know that someone has to own the actual folder. And then if you want to delete an item, it's still accessible by every other collaborator. So what you have to do is manually go through your files, remove each person individually, and then delete the file. And so what Teams Drives does is it completely removes an ownership tied to one person. So instead of saying, okay, person A owns this folder, and so they're the ones that have to manage it, Team Drives removes it and says, this is the team drive and people access it, which means it's very easy to add and remove people. And it can also help get around those pesky limits of per user, because Team Drives isn't going to take up each individual person's storage limits, especially if they're using a free plan, which leads me into reason number 3, G Suite for Business is awesome. And that is because it's so easy to share files with people who are outside of your organization. And like I just mentioned, if you're sharing it with a team drive, it's not going to take up their storage. So if you have a temporary worker or contract to someone, you can give them access to a team drive that's maybe like 3 or 4 terabytes big, and they're going to be able to access all those files, use backup and sync, and not, or drive stream now, and not have to worry about hitting their own personal drive limit. Whereas in the past, if someone wanted to add their files to the Google Drive, to their own Google Drive, it would fill up their personal storage, whatever their personal storage is. So what's really great is you can pay $12 a month for 3 or 4 users, kind of your full-time people or just your co-founders, and then you can have external people with their personal Gmail addresses access the team drive, and now you've kind of hacked the system a little bit, and you're not paying $12 for every single person, and not every single person has to have a business license in order to access that team drive. So it's really great, especially if you're trying to collaborate with clients or doing a lot of work with contractors like we do. And of course, if you're trying to use Office 365 to do this, everybody has to have a license. You can't really get around that. So that's why we really like this particular setup, because we don't have to pay every time we have a temporary worker or a part-time contractor. Now, number four comes to analytics. This is something that I personally don't use, but I do know a lot of people like to dive into the analytics and easily see the activity of everyone on Google Drive. So you'll actually, as an admin, be able to see how many people are logging in, how much each app is being used, and a tremendous amount of data, so you can figure out what you should or shouldn't be paying for. You might find out that, hey, you know what? We don't need to be paying $12 a month because we're not using as much as we thought, so we can go down to $6 a month. Or maybe you find out that someone hasn't logged in 2 or 3 months and you go, maybe we should check on that person, right? Now, what's also great inside of your admin dashboard is you can easily add and remove users. So it gives you a tremendous amount of control over access to your files and organization. You can't actually check on people's physical inbox. You'd have to change their password and then go through so they know if you're looking at their inbox. But pretty much everything else you can see at a 30,000 foot view of your entire organization. Now, reason number five comes down to pricing. So we talked about pricing in the beginning. You're paying $6 or $12 a month. Now, if you're looking at Office 365, to get everything that we're talking about, a comparison, it would be about $20 a month. If you're looking at Zoho, I think I accidentally said Docs, but it's called Zoho Workplace or Work, you're looking at $6 a month. Now, the reason I still put Google Drive or Google Suite ahead of Zoho, even though they're around the same price, is because most people already know how to use the Google Suite of tools. Whereas Zoho, there's probably going to be a little more of an onboarding process or a little more of a learning curve just because it's not as popular. Whereas Google Drive, pretty much every contractor we've ever hired, which is past 50 now, has known exactly how to use Google Drive. We've never had to explain it to them, and it's super easy to just add and remove people, whereas Zoho, it's a little more complicated, even though you can do it. So thank you so much for watching. I sincerely hope you got some value. If you did, go ahead and hit that like button. Now, a quick bonus round. Here's a quick screenshot of how we organize our Google Drive. So we have a Drive folder for just our founders, and that's myself and my co-founder, where we have all of our kind of internal legal boring stuff and financials and our meeting notes from our weekly founder meeting. And then we created a team drive of training for each part of our business. So we have a team drive for hiring. We have a team drive for content training, sales funnel training, and then services training. So if we bring on someone who's going to help with client work, we can give them access to just the folder about services or products, and then give them access to the specific folder that has all of the client stuff. So something that's really helpful is to remove any of your process and training documents from your actual work documents. So it's very easy to segment out who gets access to what. And this is extremely important if you're hiring temporary workers or contractors, because as I've learned painfully the hard way, it's not a good idea to just give a temporary worker access to everything, because that's just a recipe for disaster. Of course, you do want to think the best of the people that you're hiring and working with, but at the end of the day, if they don't need access to a particular set of files, there's no need to do that. So thank you so much for watching. Hit that like button if you got some value. Subscribe for more reviews just like this one. And until the next, keep building the business you love.